Let's talk about health issues now. As far as we are concerned, coronavirus has become a global pandemic, and not necessarily in Nigeria. In Nigeria, luckily enough, I don't know if we'll say our black blood is strong, but we know that recently the Minister of Health, as Hani Ray, said that the second victim that we had is now negative, and of course the first, the index victim we have, is recuperating. But the President of the United States of America has called an national emergency. Let's take a look at the report quickly, and we'll be right back. All right, we do apologize for that video clip not coming up, but actually what we have there is Donald Trump saying and calling a national emergency on the case of coronavirus. And we also have here back in Nigeria that the federal government may reduce 2020 budget by ₦1 trillion. And we also know that President Donald Trump created ban restrictions from Europe to the United States of America, to the United Kingdom, to the United States of America from UK to US due to the issue of coronavirus. But right now, there's still no travel restrictions here, and we're feeling all safe. What do you think, Christopher?
Well, really, let's face it. What I'm going to say may not have popular applause, as it were. Coronavirus cannot survive in Nigeria. The question I ask myself, that Nigerian who was celebrated as testing positive, must have gone through a process. So what process now reversed him to negative?
I had that same
question. That one is fraudulent for me. Number two, I'm even skeptical that that Italian index is positive. That's me, you know. But then when you now connect all of this conspiracy theory to what Olusegun Obasanjo, the former president, said, you may not want to quickly dismiss it. Because really, we can be careful, right? Because corona is spreading across the world.
Yeah.
But guess what? I've not heard Ghana has corona. Republic of Benin doesn't have corona.
No, I think they have.
Maybe they have. Maybe
we have Kenya having their first case of coronavirus.
And, you know,
some other countries have also had.
I don't know, but all those white countries, let me just be a bit.
Okay.
They have it. But finally, personally, I have my own skepticism about all this sudden emergence of these viruses. Ebola came, they said we shouldn't eat bushmeat. It came, it went. Bushmeat, we are eating it today. Lassa is here now. Rats have been biting us for ages. Suddenly, Lassa came up with to bite us. What's it called?
SARS.
SARS came.
SARS.
We have not seen anything.
The SARS, not the Nigerian SARS.
SARS. Then, corona is coming. But guess what? They say it's surface born. Surface born. So, I have been touching this table since I came here. Maybe next week I touch this table, I get corona. How come? Wuhan, where it originated from, had been living decades the way they've been living, centuries the way they've been living. Suddenly, corona came in 2019 or 2020.
2019.
And then suddenly, Wuhan has changed. Let's face it. And look at the speed at which corona is traveling around the world. No, it's very suspicious for me.
Yeah.
It's very highly suspicious. Really, they exist. Don't get me wrong. Those strains of diseases, I call them strains because as far as I'm concerned, look at a bio attack suddenly all over the world. They exist, they come from somewhere, whether a laboratory or wherever it is, but they exist. But what I'm saying is their emergence is not natural and it's not ordinary.
Okay, quickly, Aya.
Let me just tell you this, from my background as a scientist.
Okay, quickly, please.
Technology. Let me just tell you that there is biological warfare.
Right now?
Yes. See, what is the virus? A virus is a being that cannot be on its own. It is an obligate parasite. It must live
generated
or man, yes. Me, you know, to be able to
so have a host.
And remember, just some 2 days ago, the Chinese government has come up with an allegation that the U.S. through its army brought that what do you call it?
That's the coronavirus, yeah.
To Wuhan. So
they have nailed it.
The most important thing is prevention, and I think that we've not done enough in terms of media enlightenment, public enlightenment, and all the rest. We should still be very careful. I was explaining this to some few people, you know, yesterday or so, and I said, Ebola virus came.
Mm-hmm.
We thought that that was the first time. It wasn't the first time. It had come before attacked in Sudan, the Democratic Republic of Congo.
Congo, yeah. So
there are some people from. That are somewhere there. If you read even science fiction, you know, more or less literature, you get to know this. There are some people there that are not being guided, that are, you know, experimenting one thing or the other. The EU is this. The US has budgeted about $50 billion. Tomorrow has been declared for prayers by all Americans and all the rest. So, what we should do is to be very careful. We should concentrate on preventive measures. Prevention is better, wiser, cheaper, safer than cure.
All right, thank you very much. Talking about biological warfare there. Of course, we know that on Thursday, the Naira exchanged between 405 and 420 Naira, a situation which operators said was triggered by speculations in the market as a result of the sudden crash in oil price at the international market on Monday. But currently, Naira is traded between 364 and 380 Naira. Well, as Ayobaji has rightfully said, prevention is better than cure. Let's all take precautionary measures against the spread of coronavirus. Unfortunately, this is where we'll draw the curtains for today's edition of Editors Forum. Thank you very much, Iyemi Saka, Christopher Taigbe, and of course Ayobaji. Thank you very much for being with us, and to our audience, thank you for being a part of Editors Forum, and to all those who made today's show a success, I say very much thank you. So do join us same time, same station next week, God's willing, for another edition of Editors Forum. I am Rita Omodia. God bless Nigeria.